Reinaldo.
Hi, how are
I'm
you?
I'm Hyatt. Nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
Yes. Okay, so first, I need to give you a flowers for this film.
Oh.
Incredible. The cinematography, everything was beautiful, and it was really a stunning watch.
Thank you.
So, to kick this off, I have the question. What made you choose to focus on, like, 2 years, like a short period of Bob Marley's life, as opposed to the traditional, like, cradle-to-grave biopic format?
Yeah, well, I was never interested in doing a cradle-to-grave. It's just too much story to jam in, and you know, we're trying to look for a window that gave us insight into who the man was, and it felt like we had to center it around a pretty impactful moment in his life. And we know in 1976 there was an assassination attempt on his life, and what happened after that was he doubled down and created Exodus and left us with the gift of this album, which is arguably the greatest album of the 20th century. So it just felt like a time of rich creation, rich musical genius, and also a period of time of political turmoil and what was happening in his life professionally and personally. And so it just felt like we can tap into who the human being was, the man behind the music, the lyrics, and then obviously his inevitable return to Jamaica. And just how powerful a moment that was. So there was an inherent structure with 76 to 78. Obviously, we have some flashes to his early life to prop up our A story, but yeah, it felt like a snapshot, a window into his life that encompassed, you know, all the albums that came before it, all the albums that came after it. And this film is a celebration of Bob's life. Mm-hmm. So it was also a happy time. You know, Bob went from just being a star in Jamaica to being a global star. It's what put him on the map internationally. That's why he's on every t-shirt around the world. So it's pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, speaking of t-shirts, here we go. The Wailers, I'm auditioning today.
Oh, okay. I was going to ask you to sing, but I don't think we have enough time. So what would you say is the most important message that Bob Marley tried to like share, and what do you think is most relevant today?
I think unity, peace, love. It's all in the music. Bringing people together. That's all he was about. Movement of Jah people. It was all about bringing people together. And no matter what the politics of the nations were, music is a way to heal that, a way to get beyond the divisiveness between people and nations, and especially in Jamaica, but around the world. And I think that's why his music resonates with so many people. You know, they said he was a third world superstar, and it's true. It's like he's your favorite musician's favorite musician. He just had that power, the power of his lyrics, the power of his message is as relevant today, more relevant today than when he first wrote them and performed them. So that's the power of a true legend, a true icon.
Yeah, I agree, definitely. So a number of people have tried to obviously do Bob Marley biopics and things like that, and it's obviously taken more than 30 years. What would you attribute your success to?
Timing. Sometimes timing was on my side for whatever reason, and I'm grateful for it. I felt that from the moment that the project came to me, that it was a gift, like somebody was looking out for me. And I had these strange sort of kismet things that connected me to the project. You know, my father named me Reinaldo Marcus Green after Marcus Garvey. Marcus Garvey, who studied. And it was amazing. Like it was almost written. You know, Bob lived at 42 Oakley Street. 42 is my favorite number. I did a show here in the UK, which also shot in Jamaica. So it wasn't the first time I had been to those countries to shoot. There was these strange sort of kismet signs, and then all of a sudden the script shows up, and they have the rights to the music, and Ziggy Marley's on the phone. So I have the family's approval. I have access to the music. Like, this is a gift. It's a gift. Then I wanted to run the other way because I'm like, why me? You know, I'm that little boy running from the fire.
Yeah.
But then I thought, why not me? You know, I feel like I love this man, and I want to protect him as best I can. I want to protect his legacy, but I also want to show the human being. He's not perfect. He's not a perfect person. He was human like all the rest of us, made mistakes like the rest of us, but his, as Ziggy said, I think he said his purpose was perfect, and I agree with that. I think he had a perfect purpose in life, and I hope we achieved honoring that.
Oh, that's amazing. I would say that you guys did.
Yeah.
I love the film, but that's all we have time for, unfortunately.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay. We're jamming. The thing that jamming was a thing of the past. We're jamming.
more than